In this topic, the children will be learning about computer networks, including how they work, why they're useful, and where we can find familiar, everyday examples of networks. At the beginning of the lesson, children are asked to reflect on what they understand by the terms wireless, device, and network. A network is defined as a group or system of interconnected people or things, and therefore, a computer network is a group of interconnected devices. We say devices instead of computers because some things, such as printers, are not computers but they are connected to a computer network. A computer network can be wireless or wired, and it's not the same thing as the internet. Most of the time, a network is contained within one building, whereas the internet consists of lots of different networks all over the world connecting together. Computers by themselves are great, but sometimes you want them to be able to share information and resources. In a school, for example, this can allow you to access planning, policies, and other documents without having to transfer them via USB stick or email. There are lots of examples of systems which require multiple devices to share information. It's a network that allows traffic lights to make sure the right ones are on red, amber, or green. And it's a network that allows an ATM to tell a bank that you've withdrawn money from your account. Networks also allow you to connect lots of computers to one device. So, for example, instead of everyone having their own printer using a single wire, they can all access the same printers because they're all connected to the same network, often wirelessly. It's worth reminding pupils that wireless connections like this don't rely on the internet to work. As long as both devices are still connected to the network, they'll continue to be able to share information. The children will be creating a poster to demonstrate their understanding of networks using the website Canva, so take a look at the separate video showing you how to do this.